Hi there everyone, it's your boy Tape Cut, and today I'll be breaking down Beast track from my latest EP release, Pentrad, on Quality Goods Records. I'd like to show you some tips and something new that you can use in the future projects, and let's go! I decided to add some horror here. It should be scary. So, this stuff sounds like that. So what did it start from? The point that I started this track was I opened for myself a new scale called harmonic scale or melodic scale. I don't remember exactly how what's the name of this scale, but it has some Asian color, and I can play a few notes that this scale includes. Let me find some strings and show you the example and the difference between usual minor scale and harmonic scale. Okay, legato is the best thing. Yeah. So, this track was made in E minor harmonic scale. The E minor scale sounds like this. E minor harmonic scale sounds like this. So it has Asian color. That sounds like this. I started playing with these notes, with these four notes, and I understand that it has some like really cool melody into itself. So I just decided to try make something with it, and I started from the brass. Like I did some pattern, like simple melodies here, and that was sounding like this. Let me see the first clip. So after that, I decided to add another instruments, another brasses, another horns and strings and stuff to make it sound more fat and full. So I found the sample that called that horn, though, that was made by, I don't remember exactly who did it, but that was, I don't know, Dilip maybe, or Cymatics, maybe Ikali, I don't know. Have to check it out later. And I decided to add it as a main layer. So this sounds like this. You can see that I didn't make any mixing thing here because this sample sounds really clear and powerful. So I decided to leave it untouched. I also added like strings, staccato strings. Let me see if we can have a listen to this without any side chain. Sounds scary, right? So, the whole group sounds like this. Also added the bass, just the usual sub bass, sine wave. So the next one, I decided to make a drop without any hi-hats because I'm really tired of using hi-hats for that moment, and I thought that it will be really interesting if anyone will hear a track without any hi-hats. But yeah, if you can see here, I have only hats in the intro. So, and in the drop, I have only kick and snare, and maybe some fills, some drum fills, like toms, maybe and snares. This sounds like this. I made it in Addictive Drums because I really like that VST, and this sounds really lively. So this is one of my favorite VSTs. The simple crash and feels. I do the feels like that because this sounds not electronic, maybe. This way gives drums a little bit of life, and if you have a listen to it into the track, you won't say that this is something electronic. Looks sounds sounds really, really live. My drum section sounds like this. So simple. Nothing special. The idea of track, by the way, was started when I was in New York, and that was in 2018 when I was called there by the Fool's Gold for the beat battle Goldie Awards, and I met some cool guys out there, and that was really inspiring because I met a lot of new people, some friends like Holly, Miguel, and some other guys. So that really made some inspirational thing for me, and I decided to make tracks, not only Beast, also another tracks from the EP, because I was inspired by this travel. I had a lot of good and cool moments from the city. That was my first experience performing at beat battles, so that was cool, and I think you will feel the feel my mood in this EP. So I tried it. I tried to put every emotion that I had in 2018 and till that moment. I tried to put it into this EP. So I think you'll enjoy it. So now let's have a see what do I have in this project. So the brass sections, okay, sounds good. Also, I decided to make some crazy drum fills and build up drums here. I used samples that I've recorded on my iPhone during the some football game or hockey. I don't remember exactly what was that, but there was some game that I recorded the claps, and they sound like this. It's filtered. I also wanted to use a guitar here because it gives more power, and like it sounds just aggressive, and I had to add some aggressive stuff before the drop to show that the drop part will be like something powerful. Where's that? Yeah, here's it. Now here's the strings. Here's the guitar. By the way, I use a lot of Ableton instruments to create something cool, and maybe I do it only for the draft things, because in the future I'll just remove them and add some contact instruments instead of it. What can I say about the guitar and strings and brasses and horns that I used in this project? Is they are from Ableton's site. I really like their packs, because they sound like something original, something that was really re recorded, not synthesized. The first time I tried that packs, I understood that I'll use them like for the next 3 or 5 years. I really like them. By the way, another other instruments like mallets or strings are also from these packs. You can check it out, like cellos. They sounds really live because I added Valhalla vintage reverb here. This tool give like more space for these strings. Let me show you how it sounds with this reverb and without it. Here's the strings sent. And I also like that Valhalla vintage reverb. I like to use it for other instruments like violas, brasses, drums, vocals. I don't know. I like to use it everywhere because this tool is really powerful. I also like to use some cinematic stuff like rolls, effects, some drums from the cinematic packs, and they sound like this. These sounds give a lot of space and a lot of power, a lot of power to the track. Also decided to add here some horror thing to show that this part should be scary a little bit, and I think I did it well. And one little scary sample. What more can I say about this project is I didn't spend a lot I didn't spend a lot of time making this project because this was really inspiring, and as I know from my experience, if you have like if you have a cool idea, the track will not be making will not take a lot of time to finish it because you I don't know, it feels like you felt or fall into the big sea, and I don't know. It has a lot of emotions that I feel in the same time, and that's why I can finish a track. I don't know, in a day, maybe in a two, because usually it takes longer. I can make other tracks for weeks, for months. So this one was really fast. What do we have in the intro? Strings. Already show that. Oh. I didn't tell anything about my build-up drums, expect the claps I've already told about. I used a lot of layers to create this build-up, because I thought it needs a lot of middle frequencies. So I added like low claps, claps and snares, and low kick. Also like making these rolls. Because in the context you don't hear any, no, you don't hear each of these snares. You hear the whole group. It's like the ghost, it's like the ghost snares. I also like these stumps. It sounds really fat. And I think the last thing I think that the last thing that I will show you will be the main synth that I made in Serum. Looks like I have only WAV file here. So it wasn't so so difficult to make this synth, because how I usually make synths in Serum, I don't know, I take sine wave, maybe distort it a little bit, add some LFO on that, and resample all that stuff, and making the melodies, automations, and modulation and stuff. And then I just export it as a WAV file, and trying to cut everything and just messing around with that stuff. And also one of my favorite tools is sidechain reverb, because it gives a lot of it doesn't give anything, it just fills the empty places in the track. Let me show you how this sounds. Sounds dry. But if I add this chain, this gives a little bit movement into this channel. So, and of course, some bass samples, maybe from my older sample packs, like Tape Cut Drum Kit Volume 1 and Tape Cut Drum Kit Volume 2. Here they are. this one. Yeah, I also like making the automations for the EQ bands and add some movement into it, then distort and stuff. Also, I like to add some sub bass into each sound. This just repeat what I have in the channel above. This thing I also made in Serum, but I can't now show the preset because it's in the WAV file. So I think we saw everything in this project, and you learned some new things. If so, I will be happy. And there was tape cut. Listen to my EP on Quality Goods Records. Peace.